listen here. A equal to A comma B comma P. B equal to 2 comma 3. C equal to P comma Q comma R comma S. Then N of A union C cross B is dash. So N of A union C cross B. Already what we have studied? N of A cross B is equal to what? N of A into N of B. Isn't it? Similarly, here N of A union C into N of B. So N of B, very well you can write. N of B is equal to, what is it? N means what I told you? Cardinal number. Number of elements present in the given set. You have to count the number of elements. How many elements are here in set B? 2. So cardinal number of B is 2. Next, you have to find out the cardinal number of A union C. How many elements are there in A union C, isn't it? So first, what you have to find out? A union C. What is A? A comma B comma P. Union P comma Q comma R comma S. What is A union C? So A B P, again P is coming. Is it necessary to write one more time? No. In the set, elements are written only once. You should not repeat the elements. Do you follow? So, you should not write P. Next, what you got to write? Q, R, S. Changing the order of the elements, it is not problem. It won't affect the set. Instead of writing like this, you can write P, Q, R, S, A, B. You can write like this or this. Changing the places, it won't affect. But elements, you should not repeat it again. Only once you must write. So, this is the answer. But what do you want to find out? N of A union C. What do you want to find out? N of A union C. You found out N of B. Next, what do you want to find out? N of A union C. What is N of A union C? How many elements are there in A union C? Cardinal number, number of elements present in this set. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, N of A union C cross B equal to N of A union C into N of B. This is into, because cardinal number. N of A union C is how much? 6. 6 into 2. 6 twos are 12. 6 twos are 12. Do you follow? So what is the answer here? 12 is the answer. What is the answer? 12 is the answer. Suppose A union C. If you are confused with the two alphabets, then you can represent this A union C as, because you have studied like this only, isn't it? So, you can represent this let. Let A union C equal to some other alphabet you can choose. What you can keep? D. A union C equal to D. Do you follow? That means N of A, in the place of, actually what they have given? A union C cross B. How can you write this? N of D cross B. That is N of D into N of B. That means what are you going to find out? D equal to what? A union C. Already we found out the answer. The same way you can find it. So in, without writing this also, you can find out the answer from the question itself. What is A union C? A, B, P, Q, R, Yes, that is D. So instead of n of A union C, you can write n of D equal to 6. N of B equal to what? 2. Therefore, n of D cross B equal to n of D into n of B. That is equal to what? 6 2s are 12. D is nothing but A union C. D is nothing but A union C. Do you follow? But is all the step, is it necessary to do it in the exam? No. I told you, since this is 1 mark, you have to do it within a minute. You should not take such a long time to do it. But first time to memorize the concept, to understand the concept with the detail, when you want to learn, you can do all these things. Otherwise, first A union C. Just you see, A, B, P, 3 here. P is not there. 3 plus 3 is 6. So, 6. Next one is B. That is 2. 2. So, 6 2s are 12. So, this is the answer. Do you follow? So, no need to do all these things. So, those who are able to do it directly like this, you can do it. Do you follow?